Hey guys, just a quick message before this video starts. Just want to give a quick shout out to the Essential New Truckers Handbook by Malcolm Green. It is a book absolutely rammed with information regarding anything HGV related. Don't care whether you're new in the industry, whether you've been in the industry for 5 years like myself, or whether you are a veteran in the HGV world and you've done more miles in reverse than I've done forward, there is something in this book that will benefit you, I absolutely promise you. We're talking taco rules and regulations, how to strap a load, how to hitch up to a trailer, and also how to even get your HGV license in the first place. Everything that you need to know is in this book. Promise you, you won't regret it. Link is in the description down below if you are interested. The Essential New Truckers Handbook by Malcolm Green. Anyway, enjoy the video.
What's up?
Bring all the highs and lows. Said I'm gonna win, though the world might spin. Now I'm sitting here like I'm no one.
Welcome to my channel. My name is Luke. Thank you very much for watching. Do appreciate it. It is 5 a.m. in the morning. I've just got into work. I'm just doing some daily checks, and then we'll be out of here. Everything's looking good so far. How are you all doing? You right? Oh, there's a spider there. Nice. Today's Friday. I'm loaded to go to Leicester this morning. We were supposed to go yesterday, which was Thursday. But there was a miscommunication somewhere, and the place I'm delivering to closes at 2:30, and I didn't get loaded until gone 12 in Tetbury, so yeah, I wouldn't have made it. It's a good 3-hour drive up there from Tetbury, and they normally, well, they don't take deliveries after 1:30, but they were willing to extend it to 2:30, if I made it by then, but I wasn't going to make it by then. So the plan is we're going to take it up there this morning instead. Like I said, today's Friday. Don't know what's planned for afterwards. I was supposed to go into Lichfield, get a load for Iceland and bring it back, but I don't know whether I'm doing that today or not. I haven't been told. So yeah, for now the plan is get in my truck, warm up, wake up, and take this to Leicester. It's a good 2.5-hour drive up there, and then by the time it's offloaded it's going to be a good 3.5 hours time, and by then I should know what I'm doing because it'll be gone 8 o'clock then in the morning. So yeah, happy days. Hopefully, I think this vlog is going to be quite a short one because I'm just recording just the one day. But hopefully you enjoy it nonetheless. Right, let's go. We've got to do some miles now under us. Get some miles under us, rather. And get to Leicester. I'll see you in a bit. I'm a mess, just trying to guess my way through this. Just don't get enough of me.
Want any beef?
There's a noise in there.
Just don't get enough from me. Just don't get enough from me. Wanna go back in time when everything seems so clear.
When the problem. Good morning! Hello, I've already said welcome, but yeah, we're in the truck. We've been driving, I do apologise for the background, it's probably a bit messy at the moment. Yeah, we've been driving for about nearly 2 hours now. Didn't take quite as long as I thought it was going to take to get here. Made up quite a bit of time on the A roads because it's up and down hills, and I thought it was going to be a bit slow going up the hills, but I mean I was, but not enough to slow us down too much. So we're actually bang on R7 by the time we get there. It's 7:28 right now, so we'll be there in 2 minutes. And they said the earliest they would take a delivery is at 7:30. So yeah, we're going to be there bang on time. Whether they offload us or not, though, is a different matter. But as I said, I don't know if I did say. I phoned him yesterday to tell him that I was going to be there between 3 and 4 p.m. And they said the latest they can do it is 2:30. Any later, they won't offload me. So that's why I couldn't go there yesterday, and I've had to go there today. But they said the earliest is 7:30. So yeah, we're going to go there anyway. So they should hopefully be expecting me. Whether we're the only truck there or not, I don't know. We'll have to wait and see. Could be a queue of trucks. I got no idea. This is a bit tight. I'm going to have to wait for him to go before I continue. Yeah. So, someone said on my last video, if they were paid £1 for every time I said the word tight, yeah, you'd be rich, mate. You'd be very rich. I do say it a lot. It's like my favourite word. Oh, that's tight. Oh, that's tight. It's my favourite word. Anyway, we're nearly there. 700 yards, 600 yards. I think it's on the right-hand side. I think. We shall see. I don't even know the name. What is it? EM Building Supplies or something. Looks like a relatively big yard. Obviously I've researched before I go. It looks like I turn into the right and a bare left. That's where deliveries go by the looks of it. So I like to know. Like have an inkling of what I'm doing. Do you know what I mean? Like if I gotta turn up and hope for the best, then so be it. But I would rather I know. Yeah, you just pull out, mate. I'll slow down. To be fair, he probably thought I was turning in right there, but he's still after his junction. I'm indicating right because I don't know where the entrance is exactly. That looks like the exit, so it's this one here. Yeah, it looks like you just drive around in a big circle. Lovely. We're going to drive straight in. We can make the gap there. You can come out this way as well by the looks of it. Brilliant. Okay, there's a boat there on a forklift. Goodson Woods, customer collections. We want to go straight on there. Okay, we are now just around the corner from our next job. We got tipped off in Leicester earlier, where you last saw me. We had 40 bags on. All those bags come off. I've been asked before, how come you can carry 40 bags? You'll be overweight. They weigh nearly a ton each. No, not all of them, because I was delivering topsoil. Half the load was topsoil. And the other half of the load was bark. And the bark bags are so light that you can pull them, basically, with one hand. They're so light, and they basically just sit on the top. And then they're all strapped up. So that's what I did there. Yeah, they offloaded me pretty quickly there. I was offloaded within about 35 minutes. And then we've just made our way over to Lichfield, which is where we are now. We're going to go into a company down here. I can't remember what they're called now, but I've been here loads of times before. I get loaded with 22 pallets of water. That's what we get loaded with, and then that's going to go to Iceland and Switzerland. So it's literally what we were supposed to do yesterday. There's a cart in there, but today instead. So yeah, happy days. And then once that's delivered in Iceland, I don't know how long I'm going to be in there for. We've got to meet up with a colleague and do a trailer swap. So, but we're not sure where that's going to be yet. It could be in Avonmouth, which is where he needs the trailer, or he could be well ahead of me and come all the way to Swindon to get the trailer to go back. So yeah. Anyway, Rockland, UK. This is where we're going. I've been in here loads of times recently. Doesn't look too busy, so that's good. We've got to go in here on the right hand side. They must be doing this up because every time I come here, it looks different. Every time I come here. Yeah, we come in here, we park up, we take our paperwork / reference number in, and may give us some paperwork to tell us what we're getting loaded with so that the forklift driver can load us with the right stuff. But yeah, every time I come here, they like put new signs up and everything. Anyway, we are gonna go backwards where we are. Getting a bit close there to him. There we go. Just park up here and right, let's go and get our paperwork. See you in a bit. Right, we're loaded. Fully loaded. The thing is, with delivering to Iceland is you never know what time you're supposed to be there. Yeah, either way, we're going to head straight there. We're going to head straight to the gates, give the reference number and see what the bloke says. But yeah, last time I turned up, I was there an hour and a half early. And they sent me away, so I just waited outside. So it could be the case we do that again today. I'm not sure. But we will find out. We will find out when we get there. So yeah, fully loaded. Let's make our way to Iceland now. Hopefully we get let straight in, straight on the bay, get tips, and then we can organise where we're going to meet up with my colleague Andy to swap trailers over. But yeah, right, see you in a bit. Okay, you join me in Swindon. We're on Great Western Way at the moment. I think this road was closed a few nights ago. I think someone died on this road. Very sad. Very sad. Not what you want to be involved in, is it really? Bless him. That was a Ferrari! Sorry, my thoughts went completely away then. The Ferrari, I was like, whoa! Anyway, so yeah, just around the corner now from where we need to be. We need to go right around this roundabout. Temporary traffic lights. It's really annoying, like part-time signals. Really annoying. Can be a nightmare to get out of here. Where's that? We're good. Okay, the car is coming around, but we accelerated out before he came around that corner. One of the things about being a heavy vehicle. Left as we're coming off. To the sides. Excellent. I'm pretty sure you never used to be able to come in this way. Oh, you. That does my head in when people press the lights on traffic lights to cross. Fair enough. But don't cross before they actually change. It was the cyclist that's gone. He's cleared off and we've had to stop for no reason. You didn't need to press the button. Right, anyway, we're coming off. Yeah, as I was saying, this used to be, I'm pretty sure, 90% sure, this used to be a bus only lane. And you can only get in here if you're a bus. But it looks like you can get in here now regardless. I don't know whether that is right or not. You're definitely allowed in, I'm just not sure if you're allowed out. I want to have a look. No, it's bus only out. Okay. Right, looks like he's been told he's got to come back later. Looks like Ian up there's been told he's got to come back later as well. We might be joining them in a minute. Because I'm not entirely sure what booking time we got. Let's hope it's 1 o'clock, because if it is 1 o'clock, it's 20 to 1 now, so they should let us in. If they don't, then we can get a break in anyway, because we're on. Yeah, we need a break. I think someone smashed that green light. Good morning, how you doing? 4-6. What's up? I think it was 5 a.m. yesterday, I think. Oh, is it?
Yeah.
5 p.m.
Yeah.
That's the only reference I got, mate. Ooh, 5 p.m. F***ing hell.
Buddy, you have to come back at 1600. Way too early.
4 o'clock, yeah?
Yeah.
Alright, mate. Right. 4 o'clock. Okay, situation report. Situation report. Will you stop beeping? Okay, situation report. We're 4 hours early. But yeah, we got plans with this trailer, haven't we? So we need this trailer offloaded to be swapped over. But yeah, we're not booked in until 5, which poses another problem because I can only work until 7:30. So hang on, 8. No, 8 o'clock. Yeah, 8 o'clock. I can work till. So yeah, we need to get in. Like 4 o'clock when he said, get on a bay and get them off and then do something. I don't know. So yeah, we just might as well put it on break while we're here because we're not doing anything now for the next few hours. Well, for the next 2 hours at the least. So yeah. Not good, not good. Never mind. Right, I'll see you later in a few hours' time and see what we're doing. See what we're doing. See what we're up to. It's just one of those situations now where, like, I'm just gonna be chilling out now for the next few hours, which is annoying because I'd rather just get on with work. Give me a pump truck and I'll take him off. Okay, situation report. It's now 5:25. We're on the bay, we've got a red light. They've just started tipping us now. We did come in at 4 o'clock. And then we're literally waiting just over there for about an hour. And then 5:05 they got us on the bay, Bay 12 in Iceland. And yeah, they've just started going inside me, which, now that I think of it, sounds a bit dodgy. Not gonna lie, I had a little snooze on the bed. Yeah, I must have fell asleep for about an hour. Nothing else to do, so yeah, I had a little snooze. My colleague, Andy, he's actually outside waiting for me because he needs this trailer now. His trailer's got an MOT and this trailer hasn't got an MOT, so he's having this trailer for tomorrow because he's working tomorrow, which is a Saturday. And his trailer, I've got to take to DAF. Because DAF are doing the MOT, so we've got to do a trailer swap outside as soon as I'm out of here. But the trouble is, he's now waiting for me, basically. I need to be out of here now, because he can only work until a certain amount of time. We can both work till about 8 o'clock tonight, so in fact he can work 15 minutes later. But yeah, so we're just now waiting for this to get offloaded, then we can do our doors up, get our paperwork, go outside, do a trailer swap. And then I'm then going to go to DAF and Dorking and drop the trailer off. And then if there's room, I doubt there's any bloody room. And then I've got to head back solo back to the yard. So yeah, just one of those days today. I haven't been working hard. It's been one of those very easy days, a lot of waiting around. But in many ways it's harder because you're just more bored. Time drags. So, like, for example, I've now been at work for 12 and a half hours, and it's part of the HTV world, isn't it? It's part of the industry. But I'd rather be driving for 12 and a half hours than sat around doing nothing for 4 of those hours. Yeah, right, so hopefully this is off in the next half an hour. Trailer swap, see you in a bit. Right, trailer swap done. Engine start, thank you. Reset the suspension. Turn my backlight off. Woo! Time is 7:10. Yeah. He's gonna be very lucky if he makes it. He's got to go to Avonmouth. with the trailer that I did have on, and I'm now taking the trailer that he's got on, or did have on, to DAF to be looked at. Next challenge for me is trying to find somewhere to park in DAF. Now there's a bus only exit here, so we've got to spin around. All clear. Oh man, that was stupid. it took ages to get let in. Got in about out. We got in at 4 o'clock. Took an hour before we got allocated a bay, B12. And then, just gonna turn that off and have a red light on. And then when we did get allocated a bay, we were there for about an hour. Then the light turned green. I went into the driver's room and I was literally waiting in the driver's room for 20 minutes for my keys. So all the while, you know, Andy's waiting for me to come out so we can swap trailers, so we can take the empty trailer to Avonmouth to get loaded. And I'm taking this one to DAF. But anyway, nonetheless, we're out. We've got the trailer swapped. Okay, that is it. We are done for the day. We've just dropped the trailer off at DAF in Dorking. And yeah, it's 7:15 right now, and we started at 5 o'clock this morning, so 14 hours 15 minutes, so we've got 45 minutes to get back to the yard. We should be good for that. So yeah, anyway, thanks for watching, do appreciate it. Like, subscribe, and yeah, until next time, drive safe, stay safe, and I'll see you soon. Bye bye. It's a helicopter, isn't it? See you later, everyone. Bye.